हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम बालाजी राव। वेलकम टू बीआर मैथ्स क्लास। टिल नाउ वी डिड 30 प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन डोमेन ऑफ ए फंक्शन। इन दिस क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू डू प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन डोमेन ऑफ ए फंक्शन विच आर इन्वॉल्विंग विथ ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक फंक्शन। टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस क्लास इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट यू मस्ट नो डोमेन्स एंड रेंज ऑफ ऑल ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक फंक्शंस। सो फर्स्ट वी विल लर्न वॉट आर डोमेन एंड रेंजेस ऑफ ऑल ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक फंक्शंस। यू ऑब्जर्व दिस साइन एक्स, वॉट इज डोमेन एंड रेंज ऑफ साइन एक्स। इफ यू ऑब्जर्व द ग्राफ ऑफ साइन फंक्शन देन वॉट आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग दैट यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड वेरी इजिली। वॉट इज द डोमेन ऑफ साइन फंक्शन? डोमेन ऑफ साइन फंक्शन इज ऑल रियल नंबर। वॉट एवर एक्स वैल्यू यू टेक, साइन एक्स इज डिफाइंड। What about range of sine function? When you observe the graph of sine function, you can see that sine function graph always lies in between minus 1 and plus 1. So, range of sine function is closed interval minus 1 comma 1. When sine x equal to 0, what are the x values? X may be 0 degrees. Sine 0 degrees is 0. Sine pi is 0. Sine 2pi is 0, sine 3pi is 0, sine 4pi is 0. Not only pi, sine of minus pi is also 0, sine of minus 2pi also 0, like that you will get plus or minus. So, in general, what I can write here, this is of the form pi, 2pi, 3pi, 4pi, minus 2pi, minus 3pi, minus 4pi, like that. I can write that x equal to n pi, where n is an integer. So, when sin x is 0, at that time, what are x values? X is n pi. You keep this point in your mind. We use this very frequently. So, what you learn? You learn that domain of sin x is all real numbers. Range of sin x is closed interval minus 1 comma 1. And whenever sin x is 0, then x equal to n pi. Now, cos x function. What is domain and range of cos x function? For any real x value, cos x is defined. So, domain of cos x function is all real numbers. What about its range? If you observe the graph of cos x function, its values always lies in between minus 1 and plus 1. Cos x function range also closed interval minus 1 comma 1. And what is the one more point you need to keep in your mind? When cos x is 0, at that time what are the x values? X is pi by 2. Cos pi by 2 value 0. You can calculate these things. Cos 3 pi by 2 also 0. Cos 5 pi by 2 also 0. Cos 7 pi by 2 also 0. So what happened here? 1 into pi by 2, 3 into pi by 2, 5 into pi by 2, 7 into pi by 2. What you identified? Odd number into pi by 2. When x is odd number into pi by 2, at that time cos x is 0. In general, how I can write this? I'll write like this. Odd number generally we denote like this. 2n plus 1 represents odd number. 2n plus 1 into pi by 2. Here what is n? N is an integer. So what you learn about cos x? You learn that domain of cos x is all real numbers. Range of cos x is closed interval minus 1 comma 1. When cos x is 0, at that time x values will be odd multiple of pi by 2. 2n plus 1 into pi by 2. These things we use frequently. Tan x. What is domain and range of tan x? Tan x can be written as sin x by cos x na? You observe it is of the form f of x divided by g of x. This denominator cannot be equal to 0. Cos x cannot be equal to 0. Just now we learn for what values of x cos x is 0. Whenever x is odd multiple of pi by 2. Whenever x is odd multiple of pi by 2. In that case cos x is 0. So cos x not equal to 0 means x cannot be equal to 2n plus 1 into pi by 2. So this tan x is defined for all real numbers, but this is not defined when x is odd multiple of pi by 2. What about range? Range of tan function. If you observe the graph of tan function, range is all real numbers. It can give any real value. So what you learn? You learn that domain of tan x is r minus 2n plus 1 into pi by 2 and range of tan x is all real numbers. Cot x. Cot x can be written as cos x by sin x. Here, whenever sin x is 0, then this denominator is becoming 0, then cot x is not defined. So this sin x, when this sin x is 0, just now we learn at this point, when sin x is 0, at that time x is n pi. So Here sin x cannot be equal to 0. That means x cannot be equal to n pi. So what is domain of cortex? Domain of cortex is all real numbers except n pi. What is range of cortex? If you observe the graph of cortex, you can understand what I am saying here. You can see that graph, cortex will give you any real number based on x value. So range of cortex is all real numbers. So domain of cortex is r minus n pi and range of cortex is all real numbers. It is important you need to memorize all these points. You observe domain of secant x. Secant x can be written as 1 by cos x. If the denominator is 0, then this is not defined. When cos x is 0, cos x is 0 when x is odd multiple of pi by 2. So what is domain of secant x? Domain of secant x is all real numbers except odd multiple of pi by 2. I hope you are understanding. So domain of secant x is r minus 2n plus 1 into pi by 2. And what is range of secant x? This is important. You can understand these things when you know the graphs of these functions. I already done a video on graphs of all trigonometric functions. If you want, you can check that video. Or else in case if you have in your textbook, you can find these graphs. Range of secant x is all real numbers except the numbers in open interval minus 1 comma 1. You see the graph of secant x, you can observe. You don't find the graph of secant x in between minus 1 and plus 1. Whatever x value you take, secant x always gives a number which is greater than 1 or which is less than minus 1. You will never get secant x value in between minus 1 and plus 1. So domain of secant x is all real numbers except odd multiple of pi by 2 and its range is all real numbers except open interval minus 1 comma 1. Now, last trigonometric function, that is cosecant x. What is domain of cosecant x? Cosecant x can be written as 1 by sin x. Sin x cannot be equal to 0. When sin x is 0, then x equal to n pi. So, all real numbers except n pi. What is n here? N is an integer. So, domain of cosecant x is r minus n pi. And what about its range? If you observe the graph of cosecant x, then it you can easily say that range of cosecant x is r minus open interval minus 1 comma 1. So these are the domains and ranges of all 6 trigonometric functions. To understand the problems on domain of a function which are involving with trigonometric functions, this knowledge is compulsory. You observe this question number 31. We need to calculate domain of this function, square root of cosecant x minus 1. We know that whatever the expression is there in under root, it must be greater than or equal to 0. So here, what I'll write? I'll write that cosecant x minus 1 is greater than or equal to 0. You take 1 to other side, then what you will get? Cosecant x greater than or equal to 1. Now we need to find for what x values this inequality holds good. Just now we learned that cosecant x value always greater than or equal to 1 or less than or equal to minus 1. Cosecant x greater than or equal to 1 means all values are positive. Cosecant x is positive in which quadrants? In trigonometry we learned that cosecant x is positive in first quadrant and second quadrant. First quadrant, second quadrant, I can write like this, open interval 0 comma pi. Why I written open interval 0 comma pi? So here cosecant 0 is not defined. Cosecant pi also not defined. Cosecant x is positive in first quadrant and second quadrant. Na? So first quadrant to second quadrant range is what? 0 to pi. I written 0 to pi. Here I written open interval. Why? Because cosecant 0 is not defined. Cosecant pi also not defined. 1, 2, 3, 4. Again 5, 6. 5, 6. Fifth quadrant, sixth quadrant. Which is same as first quadrant, second quadrant. That means fifth quadrant means 2 pi. 2 pi to 3 pi. Please try to understand. 2 pi to 3 pi. Again, see, 4 pi comma 5 pi. In general, how we will write this? We will write like this. X belongs to, you see here, even number into pi. 0 can be written as 0 into pi. 0 is even number. Even number into pi. Even number into pi. I'll write like this. Open interval. Open interval, even number into pi. And this is observe odd number into pi. 1 into pi, 3 into pi, 5 into pi. We know that odd number is denoted by 2n plus 1. 2n plus 1 into pi. So what is domain of this function? Open interval 2n pi comma 2n plus 1 into pi. Here what is n? N is an integer. You observe this question number 32. We need to find domain of this function. You can see here sum of two functions is there. So we know that if d1 is the domain of f of x, d2 is the domain of g of x, domain of f of x plus g of x is d1 intersection d2. So first I'll calculate domain of this function, next I'll calculate domain of this function, later I'll do their intersection to calculate domain of this entire function. Domain of this function, as this is in under root, whatever the expression inside the root is there, that must be greater than or equal to 0. So here what I'll do, I'll multiply this inequality with negative number. We know that for an inequality, if we multiply with a negative real number, this inequality sign changes. When I multiply with minus, this will become cos x less than or equal to 0. Multiply this complete inequality with minus, this greater than or equal to changes to less than or equal to. Less than 0 means negative. Cos x is negative in which quadrants? Cos x is negative in second quadrant as well as in third quadrant. So what I can write here, x belongs to closed interval. Closed interval, because equality is there near closed interval, second quadrant to third quadrant. I can write like this, x belongs to closed interval pi by 2 comma 3 pi by 2. Cos x is negative in second quadrant and third quadrant, pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2, that means 90 to 270 degrees, that is second quadrant, third quadrant. And why I written closed brackets? Because equality is there. I know that cos pi by 2 is 0. I know that cos 3 pi by 2 value is 0. That's why I written x belongs to closed interval pi by 2 comma 3 pi by 2. So domain of this function is this one. Now I'll calculate domain of this one. This is in under root. Now whatever expression is there in under root, that must be greater than or equal to 0. Here sin x greater than or equal to 0 means sin x is positive. Sin x is positive in which quadrant? It is positive in first quadrant as well as in second quadrant. So what I can write here, x belongs to first quadrant and second quadrant, closed interval 0 comma pi. Because why I written closed interval? Because equality is there. I know that sin 0 is 0 and sin pi is also 0. Now I calculated domain of this, I calculated domain of this. To calculate domain of this full function, what I need intersection of these two sets. This is first, second quadrant, third quadrant. This is first quadrant, second quadrant. Understanding, this is second quadrant, third quadrant, this is first quadrant, second quadrant. In these two, which quadrant is common? Second and third, first and second. Second quadrant is common in both. So when we do their intersection, I'll get the second quadrant. Second quadrant means what? Pi by 2 to pi. So closed interval pi by 2 comma pi. This is domain of this function. I hope you understand this. You observe this question number 33, domain of this function. Whatever the expression is there in under root, that must be greater than or equal to 0. That means logarithm of 1 divided by modulus of sin x. This must be greater than or equal to 0. Log of something is there. That means this expression must be greater than 0. 1 divided by mod sin x. This must be greater than 0 because logarithm is defined for positive real numbers only. And one more thing here, this is of the form f of x divided by g of x, na? This denominator cannot be equal to 0. That means modulus of sin x cannot be equal to 0. Here in the base nothing is given, that means common logarithm will be there, that means base 10 will be there. As per the definition of logarithm, you take 10 to this side. As 10 is greater than 1, inequality remains same. You will get like this. 1 divided by modulus of sin x is greater than or equal to 10 power 0 is 1. I hope you are understanding. 1 divided by modulus of sin x greater than 0 and modulus of sin x not equal to 0. You observe this is greater than or equal to 1. This is greater than 0. Both are same expression only. So when I take intersection of these two, what I'll get? 1 divided by modulus of sin x greater than or equal to 1 and modulus of sin x not equal to 0. Now I need to find x values which satisfies both the conditions. So this is positive, as modulus is there, this expression is also positive and this value is not equal to 0. As both are positive, I can take its reciprocal. When both are positive, when I take its reciprocals, inequality changes. What is this? 1 by mod sin x reciprocal is mod sin x. Mod sin x. See, when I write its reciprocal, inequality changes. Greater than or equal to changes to less than or equal to 1. You see this, modulus of sin x less than or equal to 1. We learned this. Modulus of x less than or equal to a. Whenever modulus of x less than or equal to a, then we'll write like this. Minus a less than or equal to x less than or equal to a. You just apply this formula to this. Then what you will get? You will get minus 1 less than or equal to sin x less than or equal to 1. Now the point is, for what values of x, sin x value lies in between minus 1 and plus 1? For what values of x, sin x value lies in between minus 1 and plus 1? So for what x values satisfies this inequality? all real numbers satisfies this inequality. Now you see here, modulus of sin x not equal to 0. Whenever sin x is 0, then modulus of sin x is 0. When sin x is 0, what is x? X is n pi. I hope you are understanding. Where n is an integer, we discussed this in the beginning. When sin x equal to 0, x is n pi. Okay, now we need the x values which satisfies both the conditions. I'll get all real numbers except n pi. I hope you are understanding. So what is domain of this function? Domain of this function is all real numbers except n pi, where n is an integer. I hope you understand this. You observe this question number 34. By seeing this problem, you may worry because your greatest integer function is there. But actually, this problem is easy. You always believe in the concept and apply the concept. You observe here, this is f of x into g of x. If d1 is the domain of f of x, d2 is the domain of g of x. The domain of f of x into g of x is d1 intersection d2. D1 intersection d2. So what I'll do, I'll calculate domain of this function. Next, I'll calculate domain of this function. I'll do their intersection. Now, domain of this part. Step x domain is what? Greatest integer function domain is what? Greatest integer function is defined for all real numbers. So it is very easy. Domain of step x is all real numbers. Now, I'll calculate domain of this part. You observe this is sine of something. Sin x domain is what? Sin x domain is all real numbers. So this is defined for all real numbers. But here it is of the form f of x by g of x. Na? Whatever is there in the denominator that cannot be equal to 0. That means step x plus 1 cannot be equal to 0. Now I need to find the x values for which this expression is not equal to 0. First thing, when step x will be 0? When step x will be 0? Whenever I take x value in closed interval 0, open interval 1. You take any number in this interval, substitute in this. Step 0.9 is 0. Step 0.1 is 0. That means whatever expression is there, that cannot be in this interval. When I take this x plus 1 value in this interval, then this expression will become 0. First, I'll calculate for what x values this expression is 0. Later, I'll remove from real numbers. Okay, now this complete inequality, you subtract with 1, 0 minus 1, that is minus 1 less than or equal to x plus 1 minus 1, plus 1 minus 1 will get cancelled, x less than 1 minus 1, 1 minus 1 is 0. Domain of sin x is all real numbers, but we need to eliminate the numbers for which step x plus 1 is 0. So from real numbers, I need to remove this interval, minus infinity to open interval minus 1. Union. You see in this minus 1 is not included because minus 1 is there here. When I write x is minus 1, this will become 0. Union 0 to infinity. So domain of this part is open interval minus infinity comma minus 1 union 0 to infinity. Domain of this is all real numbers. Domain of this is this I got. And you see here what I need finally. Domain of this entire function is intersection of these two intervals. This is all real numbers. This is not all real numbers. This set is subset of this. When A is subset of B, A intersection B is A only. So when I do intersection of these two, again you will get this only. I hope you are understanding. D1 intersection D2 is what? Minus infinity comma minus 1 union 0 comma infinity. So domain of this function is this. I hope you understand this. These problems initially you may feel difficult, but you can overcome this difficulty only with practice. If you like this video, please drop a like. It gives me much more energy to create many videos. And share these videos with your friends. In case if you are not yet subscribed to my channel, subscribe now. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. Bye-bye.